previous blog, we have discussed about retrofit request method GET, and in this particular blog, we will be discussing about how to implement POST as a request method in retrofit network API call in Flutter. So the first thing is we need to add the dependencies here. So we are adding retrofit and JSON annotations under dependencies, and under the developer dependencies we are adding retrofit generator and build underscore runner. So now let us dive into the code. So before getting started, don't forget to add these dependencies under your pubspec file, and also you can specify the versions here, but as a part of this tutorial I have not specified any versions currently. So now let us start with the main.dart here. So we have initialized our program with a void main, and we have provided the myapp class which is extending a stateless widget here. So inside the home we are extending another class called home which is extending a stateful widget here. Here we have declared a boolean variable, and with the help of which we will be loading our widgets later on. So here now let us see how we declare our API and the request methods here. So under an abstract class REST client, we have specified our API here, the JSON generator, and here we have declared a POST request method. So with the help of this POST request method, we are passing a number here. So we will be posting a number to this particular API, and we will be fetching the data, and we will be populating the data onto our screen with the help of a widgets. So this is a simple thing. We have declared an API and a POST request method, and the two variables name and age here. So as I said earlier, in the we need to generate a class using our retrofit generator, so which we have specified in our developer dependencies, right? So for generating the file, we need to write a command in terminal: flutter pub run build underscore runner build. So using this command, we will be generating a file here. So as you can see, I have already generated the file here. So here you can see the command has started working, and it will be generating this particular file for you. So as it is specified here, this is a generated file, and you should not modify any things here. So here we are taking the two parameters name and age, and we are fetching the data here. So the data you have provided in post underscore API is being used to generate this particular file. So you can see the same URL you have specified here, and the details of the post API are being used in generating this generator file here. We have provided a sample design here. It's a raised button. So inside which we have provided onPress, and by using which we are loading the data by fetching it from the API here. So you can see we are passing a input as 2 here. You can see the get task method which will accept a number here. So we are posting this particular number here to the method, and by which it will be called with the API, and our data will be fetched. So after fetching the data with the help of a build post widget method, we are posting the data onto the screen here. So the same way which we do in the get in the previous tutorial, we are using the same way, but this change is that in the previous tutorial we have used the request method get, and now we are making the request method as post here. So you can see in the previous tutorial we have not passed any variable here, but now we are posting a data, and we are fetching the data of that particular element. So in this way we are populating the data onto the screen on button click here. So now let us see the output once. So here you can see the raised button fetch post here, and by tapping on it, so we have get the data here. On tapping on the raised button here, you can see we have populated our widget here, the name and age. As you can see, if we try to run the same URL from the browser, you can find the same data here. So we have passed the indent as 2 and we have got the name, age, and the same thing we have populated on our application screen too. So this is how we implement a retrofit network API call with a request method post. And the tutorial for this code is available in the description section below. And if you are having any queries in the implementation level, do let me know in the comment section. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content coming on Flutter.